and YouTube. And it's not a Telecaster. This week is a non-Telecaster, so welcome back to Acoustic Corner. I'm using a different camera, so I'm not quite at the same 1080 HP. I'm only at 720. I don't even know if you'll notice. So this is a Faith Acoustic. I'm fixing up for my pal, who was a wee bit sneaky about it, telling me that all it needed was a wee setup, and actually what it needed was quite a lot of work done on these frets. But sorted now. This is the one that I'm going to stick an insert in now. Hey YouTube, I'm doing this, just fixing up this, this Faith Acoustic. Just needed the truss rod adjusted. The truss rod wasn't connected. I needed a couple of turns before it even engaged. But I was put these things, see, to take out the bridge pins, you know, use one of these things. Don't use pliers. We've all used pliers. We've all had an acoustic that's someone using pliers, so they're all chewed up. See the bridge pins? I've never seen these before. Maybe it's a Faith thing. Look. There's actually a hole. This is basically why I'm doing this video. There's basically a hole in the middle of the bridge pin that you put the ball end through. So it kind of works like that kind of idea. I've never seen that before, ever. I always felt that bridge pins were a bit of a shit thing, though, to be honest. Like, the standard ones, it's just... There must be a better way. I understand, like, you know, hundreds of years ago, attaching the strings with the pins, but I was never really keen on the actual concept of these things. But I mean, these were tough to get out. You know, really, I was constantly moving them up a wee bit at a time. I hadn't had the inside to push them and all that. So a bit fidgety and annoying. Basically, that was my rant. How long does a video have to be for YouTube? Has to be more than an hour and 25 seconds, doesn't it? Yeah, thanks to everyone for coming to came to the gig on Saturday night and for watching the live stream last night. I'm pure hungover today. I'm gonna rethink my live streaming. I think I'm not gonna drink a whole bottle of Bucky. I don't think. I don't really remember what I was talking about last night. I think I'm gonna have to go through and sort of unlist all those videos because I think I was quite offensive. I think I called someone a bitch and I was like, oh, I kind of remember, and it's like. I know I was trying to be funny, but I can't really do that live. It's not right. You know what I mean? It's different if you're sitting with your pal. Well, that's a problem. I've got too friendly with your lot. I even left an incredibly insulting message with Mr. Whitesnake. I don't know whether it actually made it through in one of his videos. Just telling him that his guitar was absolutely awful and Japanese. Obviously it's him, so he knows it's meant to be funny, but I don't know if YouTube thought it was funny. They probably just went, hate comment. Banned because he's not responded to it. So yeah. So just these pins. I'll do a wee video of this later on. So it might be. I can't really be bored editing this into the other video. Maybe I will. What time is it? It's 4:30. Maybe I've got time. So this might be a separate wee 2 minute video about Faith bridge pins being a bit odd. So I'm basically just going to. I've done the truss rods. I'm just going to do the fretboard, and I suppose check make sure there's no high frets. Although it was playing okay with old strings on it. And then polish up the frets, and then that's it done. So this might be a really short video, this might be a part of another video, or I might not put it up. Rockin', catch you later. About these bridge pins, which are a bit mental, you kind of put the string through the bridge pin before it goes in. It was really difficult to get them out. If you've got one of these guitars, make sure you definitely have some sort of actual proper string pullery thing to take them out, because it really was kind of like, why are these not coming out? What? And it's like, you know, normally when you pull these up here, sometimes a wee bit to get it going, and it's like, oh, they break the seal when they come out. These ones you have to kind of pull them out all the way. It's quite difficult. I was worried about breaking them. So this is not an electroacoustic in any way. It's just an acoustic, a very light. It's got quite nice wooden binding around the outside. It's a Faith Jupiter. Yes. And it's got diamond inlays. So I've ordered the fretboards dealt with. There's a really high fret in here, causing things to go crazy all over the place down the truss rod. Stuff like that. Because I don't have the loop pedal, I don't really know how to play acoustic. I don't really ever play acoustic. I never really play acoustic. I was going... Basically, you can still remember some of the songs that you probably haven't played for 20 years. There's something going on with this guitar. I'm not really sure exactly what it is, but listen, I mean, was it there? Okay, strings are ringing up here. Maybe it's just because it's so light and resonant. That's really annoying me now. Now that I've noticed that, I've not noticed that until right now. It's like the strings up here are. You put an elastic band around the top. I have seen people do that before. You know, you get some sort of mute to put it on there. Is that one there? Which I think you used to get this problem with Fenders as well, where they put the string tree, because obviously when you hit a note, you get like a vibration thing going on. I noticed this in Sabbath band, even when I'm talking, you can hear it. Because I'm singing A. 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 On any guitar, this happens. This is actually, I decided I've got a couple of Washburn acoustics and I had them hanging in the wall. And it was impossible to do videos because I was standing up. Every time I spoke, they would echo depending on what note it was I was hitting. You know, if I accidentally spoke in the key of A, the A strings would ring, which they do on all the guitars on the wall anyway, but because they're electric, it doesn't matter. But on acoustics, you can actually hear it, so you end up with this mad echoey thing that echoes some things and not other things. Mental. I don't think it really stands to have lots of acoustics. I think you just want one acoustic and then maybe... Yeah, so... I reckon what you want to do is put an elastic band on the top. To me, that sounds like a design flaw, because obviously these ones have a specific note they go for. So ideally, you want them. It's always going to make a note, so you want it to not be one of the main notes you always hit. You don't want it to be A. E's not one of them. It's gone. If I hold it there, nothing. If I hold it there. Weird. Maybe I'm just getting too sensitive. And maybe I'm a bit hungover as well. I think if I've got something I can put around that, just to make sure it's definitely going to stop it. I don't really have, I mean, that's a hairband. I don't think that's enough. Is that enough? Is that going to even fit around it's not going to fit around the headstock. The idea was there. I don't really want to put tape on it in case it marks it. Maybe it's just too resonant. I'm too picky, I think, these days. I'm that picky with electric guitars, but electric guitars, it's kind of, there's not as much of that problem where it, you know, this is the pickup on an electric guitar, which is here and here, which amplifies the sounds that come from here, whereas this is a whole vibrating thing, so any sound on anywhere on the body comes through the body and it resonates and the sound comes out. Also, I'll just give it a clean. Right, I'm gonna. Yeah, this is going by the seat, my seat of my pants. I wonder if I just. I mean, I don't even need to wrap it around the body. If I just put this on top of the strings, right? This is not actually touching the guitar. I just put a wee bit of insulating tape just on them like that, touching all of them. Well, that's stop it. Just out of interest. Could be a reverb. Yeah, I honestly don't. Maybe I just don't play acoustic enough. I've honestly never come across that before on acoustic. Isn't that mental? Actually, see, okay, this one does have a strap button here, but see, quite often, I find it totally intolerable. See, when you get like a strap, you often get a wee bit of string with it. So you get like your guitar strap, then you get a string. It's for putting round. You know, some people, the old way I put it, you'd use this strap button, and then there isn't one on the back here, you put it around the neck. I wonder if maybe that bit of string's meant to go round that as well to stop this exact thing happening. I'm going to have to look at acoustics and see if any of mine do this. I've just never noticed that. That was a crow making a noise outside. Yeah. So there we go. Very quick video. Acoustic corner. A Faith Jupiter. I was kind of, as soon as I saw it was Jupiter, I was like, it must be a song with Jupiter in it. Jennifer, Jupiter. Yeah. No, it's like obviously you think, oh, that'd be a cool name for a song. Then you start going, all right, let's think of all the words that rhyme with Jupiter. Jupiter? Yeah, no, any rhymes for Jupiter in the comments, please. And no more tellies this week. I'm not going to promise that because there might be more tellies this week. I'm enjoying playing my CSL. Rock on. Catch you later. Where's the ending? There we go.